Want to take your Windows demo or presentations to the next level? In my work at Microsoft Mechanics, I do a ton of demos. Even though I'm not always the one actually demoing, there's a good chance that I've worked on the preparation or the recording itself. So now I'm going to kick off a short series of tutorials with tips and tricks to take the technical aspects of your demos to the next level. And I'll show you the tips and tricks for demoing live or for screen capture recordings, and probably expose a few secrets along the way. So in this episode, I'm going to focus on the steps to prepare a Windows 10 PC, as well as point out a few things at the time of this recording that are slightly different in Windows 11. You know, and most of what I'll show you today, I actually learned from Mark Rusinovich, so huge thanks to him for the inspiration. So let's get started. Okay, so what I'm showing here is a common configuration that I run into almost every day. It looks pretty typical, but the only thing really good about it is that the desktop wallpaper is nice and clean. You know, I can see everything else is a mess and pretty distracting for anyone who might be watching it. And the first thing that you can see here is that the text and the elements on the screen are pretty tiny. You know, in a live event, imagine watching this from the back of the room, or if it's a video, you might be watching it on your phone screen or as a shared desktop in an online meeting with all the Chrome around it. Now, you'll notice that all the files on the desktop are not only distracting, but if it's your personal PC, there might be things visible that you don't want your audience to see. So next, the taskbar is also loaded up with even more stuff, and these things might be useful to you, but if they're not part of your demo, then everything there is just visual noise. And the same goes for what's in the system tray on the right-hand side. So let's clean up this mess. You know, first, I'm going to click on the desktop and go into Display Settings. And now I'll scroll down to Display Resolution, and from this dropdown, I'll choose 1920 by 1080. So in most cases, you'll be recording or demoing in the 16:9 format because it's what most large displays and projectors expect, and it's also more or less the standard on YouTube as well. So I'll go ahead and keep the changes. And next, I want to set the scale and layout to be 125%, and things are looking more readable already. So from a distance or a small screen, it's going to be easier to watch. Note that if your display or projector can natively handle 4K without downscaling the image, setting your resolution to 4K or 3840 by 2160 is a good thing, but your scale layout should at least be 200% or ideally 250%. And if you're projecting remotely over Microsoft Teams or Skype, Zoom, or WebEx, chances are those services will downscale the image too, which will lead to decreased fidelity and potentially lag as well. So given all those potential downsides, 1920 by 1080 is typically your best option. So I'm going to go ahead and close out of all the settings and start to take care of everything else that you see here. So next, I'll move on to the desktop icons. And for that, I'm going to right click and then view and then uncheck Show Desktop Icons. And now it's starting to look pretty clean. But let's take care of the taskbar. So I'm going to right click on a free space in the taskbar and start by removing the search. Now I'll change this option to hidden. And by the way, if you're using this now, you can do the same by hitting the Windows key on your keyboard and then start typing to search for things. This is the same, by the way, in Windows 11 as well. Next, I'm going to go ahead and uncheck Show Cortana. Then I'll uncheck the Show Task View button as well, and you can still have this functionality by using the Windows key plus Tab key. And I'll remove the Show People in the taskbar. Now I'll remove Show Windows Ink Workspace. Then I'll uncheck Show Touch Keyboard button. Then I'll remove the Touch Pad button, and it's getting better, but isn't quite there yet. Now I'm going to remove News and Interest from the taskbar by selecting it, but I'll pause for a second here because I personally like this feature. But if you're accidentally opening this a lot, you'll want to uncheck Open on Hover so that only by clicking it, it will open the News and Interest capability. So, but in this case, I'm just going to turn it off. So I've got just a few more things left in the system tray, like the clock, volume, network, and battery icons. And I like to drag these into the hidden menu area under the arrow. And I'll start with the battery, then the network, and finally the volume control. Those three controls, by the way, cannot be removed from view in Windows 11, aside from using the nuclear option of automatically hide the taskbar, which I'm personally not a big fan of in Windows 10 and earlier versions. But I'll probably have to start using that option soon. So now I'm going to actually remove the clock, and I'll tell you why. So first, the clock by definition is going to date any recorded demos. Let's say I'm preparing content that takes a couple of days or weeks, and I'm recording demos prior to publishing that content, the clock's going to immediately show that the recording's not live. The same is true if you publish to YouTube and people watch it weeks or sometimes years after publishing it. Also, if you record demos in small chunks like I do a lot, those won't line up. So your 5-minute long video potentially will span 90 minutes of recorded demos according to those clock times. So yeah, there are a lot of indicators of times elsewhere in your demos, and there's largely, you know, a lot of psychological factors playing into this, but I'm just going to remove the clock for all of this. And for that, I'm going to right click on the taskbar again and go into taskbar settings. And here you can disable a lot of what we did earlier in the taskbar's right click options. And I'm going to scroll down to turn system icons on or off and then open that. And there you'll see our clock control. And I'm just going to turn off the clock's radio button to disable it. Again, this is a setting that doesn't appear to be available in Windows 11. And I've tried the user interface, registry keys, and group policy controls that work in Windows 10 and earlier to remove it. So hopefully there'll be an option for this and be able to remove the clock at some point. So now on the right-hand side of the taskbar, it looks pretty clean. It's done now, but let's move on to the left-hand side. So one rule of thumb here is to unpin any apps that aren't part of your demo. But keep the File Explorer there because you tend to need that a lot. And now that you've gotten rid of all the files that were previously visible on the desktop, you'll probably need it even more. So I'll go ahead and keep Edge in my case because that's typically what I demo from and what I plan to demo in the next episode. I'm going to unpin Mail, then the Microsoft Store, then Microsoft Teams, Outlook, then Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. And now everything looks minimal and there are no distractions on the screen, but since I started with making everything bigger and easier to view, plus I use the command line interface a lot, one often overlooked area is the font size in the command line. So I'm going to go ahead and right click on the Windows icon to expose the admin controls and select PowerShell. Now I'll maximize the window and you'll see that despite changing our scale and layout settings in Windows, the font is still too small. So I'll just run a help command here for Netch to show you the font size. And the font, it looks like, in my opinion, should be about twice that size. So let's go ahead and change that. So I'll right click on the top header, select properties, then go to the font tab, double its size from 14 to 28, then click OK. And now that's a lot easier to read if you're in the back of the room or watching a video on your phone or a screen share. So these were just some of the steps to prepare a Windows environment for live or recorded demos. Now, another tip I didn't mention if you demo a lot was to set up another user profile in Windows to demo from. Again, this helps to ensure that you don't accidentally expose personal or sensitive information. And next up, I'm going to share a few tips and tricks for demoing from the browser in what will be a much shorter episode. So hopefully this information is useful for you. Please leave any comments for additional tips that you have while demoing. Hit subscribe if you'd like to see these tips and more. And thanks so much for watching.